In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to create this really cool parametric bubble facade. Now, what makes it parametric is the fact that we're going to be creating reporting shared parameters that's going to report all of the dimensions of each panel. So we're going to be creating a table that gives us all of the data so this can actually be constructed in real world easily with all of this information. Let's go. Now, quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. If you want to master Revit, that's definitely the best place to be with over 140 hours of content dedicated to Revit. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit. So let's get started by first creating our main shape. Then we're going to be creating the bubble panel family, and finally we're going to be putting those together and extracting all of the data from these individual complex panels. So let's get started, and this is not going to be started as a project, it's going to start as a family. So I'm just going to click on new family, and this will be a metric conceptual mass family. So let's open that up. Now here, as soon as this opens up, I'm going to open up level 1, and then on level 1, let's create an ellipse. So this will be a simple ellipse, so let's go like this, let's make it 25,000 millimeters in length and 12,000 millimeters in width. Hit the escape key a couple of times, and now let's place some reference points on these lines. So for reference points, you want to find here point element, and then you place those. So I'm just going to place one on each of the sides, just like that, or intersections with reference planes, and then I'm just going to place another two here, just dividing this, and now I'm simply going to be using the mirror tool to mirror this all the way around. Moving forward, let's now go back to our 3D view, and here what we can do is we can go to set work plane, and I'm just going to pick this left right plane. Then I'm going to open up the east elevation, zoom in a little bit, and then let's place some point elements on that work plane, just like this, and then let's place one here, here, and then let's place one like that. And again, I'm just going to be using the mirror tool to mirror this around. Now, once we have all of this, it's time to connect these points in order to create the shape. So I'm just going to select three points that are in line and then click on spline through points, and it's going to connect that with a spline. And I'm just going to continue doing this for the rest of these splines. Now, once these are done, we can simply connect them. So hold the control key, select each one of these, and then go to create form. And this is going to create our main form. And of course, we can still edit this. So if I select it, I can select individual points like this by using the tab key. And what I'll do is I'm just going to go here to the east elevation. So here I can, as you can see, I can set it up. So what I want to do is find this point, and then I want to move it all the way down, just like that, kind of to make the shape complete, and move this one down like so. Go back to the 3D view, and now we have the exact shape that we're looking for. Now I'm going to select this form, and I'm going to click on divide surface, and it's basically going to divide it just like this. I'm not going to change the layout, I'm happy with the layout as is, and I'm going to leave it at no pattern for now. Now it's time to create the actual panel. So for the panel, we need to go here to the file menu, and then let's go to new, family, and this will be a metric curtain panel pattern based. Hit open. Now here we're going to stick to the current layout. We first need to add dimensions, which is going to make this a reporting family, so we can get each of the dimensions accurately. So for that, let's go here to set work plane, and then I'm going to select the top reference plane, or the horizontal reference plane of this line. And then let's go to our aligned dimension, And then we can go from this point to this point and place that dimension. Next, I can go here to set, select this one, and then go from this point to this point, place that dimension. And I will just repeat that for the horizontal ones as well. Now we have our dimensions and it's time to turn those into parameters. So you simply select the dimension, then you go here to label, and then you click on create parameter. Here we need to name this, however we are going to be making some changes. So this will not be a simple family parameter, this will be a shared parameter, it will also be an instance parameter, and we're going to check on reporting parameter. Now we need to select the shared parameter, so let's go to selected and yeah, let's choose one now. So here what we'll do is we're going to create a shared parameter file, and I'm just going to create that on my desktop and let's call it the test parameter. Hit save. And now once we have that, here we need to create a new group. So let's call this one the panel group. Click OK. And now we need to add a new parameter. So let's add a new parameter. This will be W1 for width. And this will be a length parameter. That's fine. Click OK. Pick that one. That's it. OK. And as you can see here, it entered that name. It's a reporting parameter and we're done. And now I'm just going to be repeating the same process for the rest of these. As you can see, now we have the W1 and W2 for the widths and the D1 and D2 for the distances or these lengths here. Okay, so once we have this created, now it's time to create the actual bubble, the exciting part. So for that, let's go here to point element. And then I'm just going to place it here. You can just place it on the reference lines, or in this case, I'm just going to be placing everything on level one, just like that. So create those two, just like that. So they are host driven. And I'm just going to select these two and use spline to through points to connect these. And also let's check is reference on this one. Okay, now let's add an additional point here in the middle. So just like that. So there in the middle. And now I'm going to be hosting another point on top of this point because I need to have that offset. So let me show you. Just go here to point element and then let's set the work plane to the horizontal work plane of this point. Just like that. Go here to draw on work plane and just click like that. Now it's going to give you a warning saying that this Revit is not happy because it has two points on top of each other. That's completely fine. You go here to modify, you select that additional point and then you pull it up just like that. Now what is important is this offset parameter that we get here, and let's turn this into an actual family parameter by clicking on it. Let's create a new one. Let's call this one H. For height, make it an instance parameter and then click OK. Now for this particular parameter, we need to add a formula because I want it to be powered by the distance here, so the length of the family. So for that, let's open up our family types, and then in the family types for H, let's add a simple formula of D1 divided by 6 and hit apply. Okay, and now we have that. Finally, to create the shape, you select the first point, hold the control key, add these two points, and go to spline through points. Make it reference by clicking is reference, just like that. Then you want to use the tab key to select only this side, hold the control key, select this side, and oops, don't do it like that. So again, you need to use the tab key. I didn't, just like this, okay, using the tab key. Adding all of that together by holding the control key and clicking on creating form to have something that looks like that. Okay, so now we have our bubble panel created. Let's hit save and save it on desktop and let's call it the bubble panel. Hit save and now we can load it into the project and close it just like that. And we're inside of our project. So here I'm going to select our shape. go to Pattern, and then for our pattern, let's find the bubble panel. Click on that, and it's going to be applying now that bubble all over our structure, and this is what that looks like. So as you can see, we have our beautiful bubble facade now, or bubble paneling. Now, what's even more beautiful about this, each one of these that you select here in the dimensions, you get the exact dimensions. So see how D1 is a little bit different than D2, same thing for the width. That's because this is while a live kind of shape, and it's not going to be perfect, and that's why we needed all of those different dimensions. We also here even get the area. Okay, so once we have all of this, what we can do is we can save it and load it into our project to create a schedule. So let's go here to save. Let's call this one the bubble panel mass, hit save, and then let's start a new project. So go to file, new project, and I'm just going to be using the architectural template. Hit okay, so it's going to open that project up. Go back to our mass. Go to load into project. Here I'm just going to click on close. So now we need to place it. So I'm just going to place it like that in the center. Hit the escape key a couple of times. Let's open up the 3D view. So this is where we're at. And now to kind of do the most important part, which is creating the schedule, let's go here to the view tab, find our schedules, create a new schedule. So for this schedule, this will be a curtain panel schedule. So pick that for the category, click OK. And now, as you can see, we have the shared parameters D1, D2, and W1, W2. So I just want to use those. So select that one, bring it in, and the same one for the W's. Okay, so we have these in. Click OK. And now here we have the schedule of all of those dimensions. So if you're going into manufacturing, you can create a complex family like this that's going to actually report all of the dimensions. So in manufacturing, they can use that to construct the panel. So if I just dock it over here on the side, what you'll notice is you can select each individual panel here, and it's going to highlight that inside of the model so you can see where each one of these is. And also, if you have some weird dimensions that you're not sure, okay, what is going on with this one? Why is it weird? Well, it's here on the edge, so maybe it's because of that, and so on. So there we go. This is how we can create complex facades and get actual data on how this can be constructed and what are the exact dimensions. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.